It has been a busy year in the news, but what were some of the stories that resonated most? From cybersecurity pieces such as the hunt for Russia's most notorious hacker, to culture stories like a look at Amazon's army of retired workers, those are just some of the stories that made Wired magazine's list of the top 12 most read of 2017. Here to discuss the articles that readers found most compelling is Nicholas Thompson, Wired's editor-in-chief. Nick, good morning.
Dana, how are you?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Doing well.
All right, let's talk about some of these, including the fake news, the idea of fake news coming out of Macedonia for profit. Why did that resonate with people so much? And then I guess the question is, can we combat it better now?
Well, all right, so that story came out in the beginning of the year. It was just after the election. There are all those stories about, wait, did fake news swing our election? So we sent a reporter to Macedonia to meet with this 18-year-old who had created a lot of fake news. And he's this totally compelling guy who doesn't actually care who wins the election. He just saw that he could make money doing stories like Pope endorses Donald Trump. And it was a look at, like, there's all this crazy stuff on the internet, but behind it, there are these real people. And some people like that.
The second story we wanted to touch on was a story about robots taking over human jobs.
Yes.
Which is obviously something that's talked about a lot. People have a lot of concerns about how real actually is it?
Well, so what the article argued is, if you look at the data, it doesn't seem like that's happening, right? And so one of the examples that stuck is ATMs. ATMs come along and everybody says, oh my God, all the bank tellers are gonna lose their jobs. It's the worst. Yeah. But it turns out that actually what it means is that the bank tellers do slightly different, more interesting things, and there are more bank tellers than there were 10 years ago. Maybe down the line, as ATMs become more successful, the tellers lose their job. But right now, we seem to have a pretty synergistic relationship with robots. We're doing okay.
Another top story we saw, a journalist created a dad bot to keep his father's memory alive. What is this technology and where might we see this going?
This is so interesting. This is one of the most emotionally resonant. One of the things I love about this list, you know, people always say, people like clickbait. They don't like clickbait. You know what they like? Emotional they like connection. Really intense, emotionally smart stories that tell us where the future is going.
Yeah. That's so
and
true.
This shows it. These are the most read stories. So in this particular one, there's a journalist. His father is dying. He doesn't have long to live. So he takes lots of recordings of his father talking and he builds a chat bot that can then sound like his father, that can talk like his father, so that his children, the grandchildren of the man who's dying, will remember him. So the story is about how to construct it, how it worked. It's a journalist with coding skills. Where is this going?
Yeah.
We have so many things recorded in our voices. Like, there will be bots that sound like us, that act like us,
For those who don't know what a chat bot is, Nick, what exactly was this?
So I type something in, and it responds the way Anthony Mason would, with your history, your historical knowledge, something about your childhood, things you've said. It talks like you. It sounds like you. In a way, it kind of is you.
Anybody who's ever lost somebody knows that voice, losing the voice, that's one of the biggest things, actually.
And so is that great or is that deeply creepy, right? And that's one of the interesting tensions in the story. He plays it for his mother at sort of the climax of the piece.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, you really can keep somebody alive that way. It's extraordinary. Yeah. All right. Also, one of the biggest stories of the year, and I think we had you on to talk about this, was going inside Apple's new headquarters, which most people would love to see.
Right. I mean, you spent $5 billion on this absolutely amazing, the circle, you call it a donut or a skyscraper on its side. And it's a wonderful story about, you know, they kind of thought of it as their most advanced product ever. And there's this great, the moment that resonates most for me is where the author, Stephen Levy, says to Johnny Ive, the designer, he says, do you really need a four-story door made out of glass? And Ive says, well, it depends on how you define need.
Need, yes.
Right? I mean, Apple has all the money in the world, right? They have all the cash in the world. They don't know what to do with it, so they built the most extraordinary headquarters on Earth. And, you know, there's not a single exposed screw. It's the total Apple product. So
it's got to look better to look good than that. Is this sort of setting the bar, though, for other companies?
It's setting the bar 20 feet high. Like, you don't have that much. No one else has that much money. No one else can do it. And there are all sorts of critics, but it's a pretty amazing
But do the
place.
Batteries in the building last
longer? They last longer every year.
The windows degrade over time, so they get replaced.
Wired's Nick Thompson. Nick, thank you. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you, too.